I'm disappointed in you. Are there any words in the English language more difficult to hear from someone we respect? When our parents have given up on telling us off and decide just to tell us that they're disappointed, doesn't that cut deeper? When someone we really like has asked us to do something for them and we've only really put half our effort into it and they give us that look, the look that says that we've let them down. Isn't that worse than if they were just to get angry? It seems to me that there is an air of disappointment over the second half of John 13. As Jesus confronts Judas' betrayal and Judas runs away, as Jesus predicts that Peter, one of his closest friends, will disown him not once but three times. I don't know if Jesus felt disappointed by his disciples at this time or indeed later when they ran away. But I do know that when push came to shove, they let him down. And in the middle of all this, as they are letting him down and they're going to, Jesus gives the disciples one of his most important instructions. A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Even as they are disappointing him, Jesus is asking them to do one of the most difficult things he's ever asked. He's talking about the same sort of self-sacrificial love that took him to the cross. He is encouraging his disciples to care for one another in such a way to put each other first, even at cost to themselves. It is by our self-sacrificial love for each other that people will know that we belong to Jesus. I wonder whether we are the sort of people who are able to do that well, to love each other so well that other people see Jesus in us, or whether we too sometimes let him down, maybe more often than not. Have a think for a moment. I wonder what other people might learn from your relationships with other Christians. If people were to watch you and the way you treated other people in the church, the way you spoke to other people in the church and the way that they treated you, what would that tell them about Jesus? It's an awesome responsibility and a real challenge that Jesus is calling us to, but he certainly thinks we can do it. Remember, even as they were letting him down, Jesus commanded his disciples to do this. And if his disciples could achieve it, I'm sure we can too. It is an awesome responsibility. Maybe you've got a relationship with a brother or sister in Christ that is a little strained, that is not as loving as it should be. And if that's true of you, I'd encourage you to make an effort today to set it right. Maybe you have just not put your full effort into loving one another. You're sort of getting by on half measures. The sort of things that might end up disappointing those who have given you a task, your parents, saying they're disappointed in you. I don't know. Maybe you need to commit afresh to loving one another in the way that Jesus has loved each one of us. Tomorrow we'll be reading John 14, verses 1 to 31.